Hey everybody, Nick here, and today we're going to try and do a little assembly and maintenance on this guy right here. This is the Klutzley Knives Swiss Border Guard Knife. So at the moment, the action is a little tight, and that's okay. And there is no blade play, and the centering is very slightly favoring the show side, but it's basically fine. So let's go on ahead and see what we can do for it. I'm hoping that we're going to get up in there and we're going to realize, oh, there's a bunch of gunk up in here, and we can make this a little bit nicer. Go ahead and start off by taking out the pivot, which is not free spinning, and although there is some thread locker, it doesn't seem to be too aggressive, so that's a beautiful thing. Then we're going to go ahead, and by the way, take a look at this. This is one of my very favorite optical illusions in the world. Okay, that's maybe a little strong. I have a lot of favorites, but both of these take the same size screwdriver. It's just because you have the wide screw here, this guy looks a lot bigger than that one. So, yeah, that's kind of entertaining. But let's go ahead and pop this loose. Beautiful. That's coming loose. Well, this is starting out to be pretty easy so far. And then we'll pop this guy loose as well. Oh, boy. Okay. This guy's fighting me a little bit more. I'm going to try a little tiny bit more torque here. Considering that the last two haven't been threadlocked heavily, I'm going to try and up that a little bit. Switching to using a ratchet style thing. And we're going to just go ahead and see. And if that doesn't work, then I'm going to call this. Oh, okay. That's fine. Just took a little tiny bit more torque. Oh, it's coming out from the other side now. That's interesting. Okay, well, whatever. I can work with this. So the back side unscrewed rather than the front side. That must mean the thread locker was a little bit unevenly applied, but that's not really an actual problem. So we'll pop that loose. Okay. So that's always a slightly dangerous game, right? If a screw doesn't want to turn. You know, in that case, I made the judgment based on the fact that the first two were, you know, relatively easy to pop loose, that I just wanted to, you know, control the torque a little bit better, and that's why I'm using this little ratchet set. And by the way, if you're ever curious about any of the tools I'm using for this assembly, go ahead and check out nickshabazz.com/tools. I have a video with all that there. So, okay, this is a button lock knife. It's not an automatic, no springs or anything like that. It is completely manual. So, see here, just kind of flops around. However, anytime you have a button lock, there will be a spring underneath the button. So you want to make sure that as you're popping this guy loose, that the button is not going to come flying off in the middle of nowhere, and indeed it did not. So that's beautiful. Okay, this is a little bit, this is more than a little bit dirty. This is actually just full of crud. All right, well, hey, hopefully by the time we're done with this, we're going to be really good to go. You know, Seagull, you're not really helping anything. And the funny thing is, like, I know that Seagull out there, who you are no doubt hearing, is just trying to, you know, find himself a partner, but he fails to consider the fact that I am not interested in seagulls, and I'm married. So it's like, dude, what are you trying to do over here? You know, I appreciate that, but you can calm it down a little bit. Go someplace where there are other gulls around, you know? Find some other gulls. Gulls just want to have fun. It shouldn't be so hard, right? I'm sorry, that was terrible. Actually, I'm not actually sorry. Okay, so what you can see here that I'm doing is I'm just cleaning off the whole track here, cleaning out the detent track, cleaning that out, not the detent track, the button lock track, cleaning off this whole area, cleaning out the pivot. Beautiful. Does the pivot pop through on this side? No, it doesn't. So I'm just going to wipe here, get rid of whatever. It looks like they used some kind of a grease initially. And greases are well and good, but not necessarily going to give me the kind of free-swinging action that I tend to do. And by the way, I want to thank very, very much my buddy Geezer's Edge. He's on the Instagram and otherwise. A very nice guy. Actually met him at Blade Show and, you know, he's been a solid human. But he actually loaned this guy my way. I'm really not doing much in the way of loaners lately. But, you know, in this case, I made an exception because it's a relatively expensive knife. And it's one that I have wanted to check out for a while. You know, I looked at a Klutzley knife way freaking back when. ACC01, I think it was. Old knife, old design. But anyways, and, you know, I was pretty impressed with lots of it, but, you know, it was using bad Teflon washes, and, you know, ultimately, you know, felt a little bit, I don't know, it wasn't my style, but I was curious enough that I wanted, you know, I wanted to check one of these guys out, and so when the opportunity presented itself, it was like, yes, yes, indeed. Totally game. Absolutely and totally game. So that made it a lot easier, but he actually was kind enough not only to loan me the knife and to let me disassemble it, but actually he was kind enough to let me remove the lanyard on it. I mean, it has, unfortunately, a lanyard on that is, like, clamped on. It's kind of weird. They've got a little length of paracord, and it's not, like, an interesting lanyard. It's just blue paracord. But it is clamped on with, like, a little piece of felt like titanium or something like that. He was kind enough and, you know, said, oh, well, you know, I hadn't removed it yet, but you're welcome to, and that's a kindness, because carrying knives with lanyards, at least to me, drives me up a freaking wall. But anyways, he didn't have to do that, of course, and, you know, that wasn't part of the deal, but he offered it of his own free will, and that was very kind of him. What I'm doing here is I'm going to use some knife pivot lube. I'm using this because the knife pivot lube tends to go a little tiny bit better with the, it tends to go a little tiny bit better with washer-based actions than the nano oil. It tends to make for a slightly smoother approach. What I'm just realizing, though, is that I kind of did that backwards. I'm looking at the blade here, and you can see here that the blade has this kind of marking on it. The blade has been smoothed out in places by the washer itself, which means that generally this washer wants to stay static while the blade spins, and that's fine. I'll let it. But I want to make sure then, you know, this isn't a crucial, oh my god, issue, but I want to try and get it such that the lubrication is on the washer and the washer stays still. Also clean, you're also lubricating the pivot here, just so that'll rotate happily. Beautiful. So I'll drop this into position here. And see here, there's a stop pin, and that works fine. Then again, I'm seeing wear on, not wear so much as polishing on one side of the washer, so I'll go ahead and put that side down against the blade. I'll lubricate there. Drop that into position. So now, next step is going to be to put the button lock back into place. There is a trick I've learned for button lock knives that very often they actually cannot be reassembled with the blade fully down against the scale. So what you have to do is actually lift the blade up just a little bit, and that allows you, there we go, that allows the button to slide in underneath there until it goes, flies off into the sunset there, as it just did. You know, I looked really, really, like, on it there for a second, but alas. The universe has a way of reminding me that I am, hashtag, not a brilliant man. So again, I lift up a little bit. That allows me to get this into position. And to prevent it from eating itself across the room again, I've actually put the blade, I've partially closed the blade here. So, there we go. So let's go ahead and drop all of this into position. Snap that into place, snap this into place. Okay, what I'm going to do here to start with is reinsert the pivot. And I'm going to do so using a little bit of a blue thread locker. I'm going to use this Loctite on a stick here. This is a very straightforward disassembly. I'm actually quite happy about that. This is going pretty well. I was a little afraid that I'd be dealing with, you know, thread locker or some other weirdness in any serious quantity, but no, this is going well. But anyways, I'm gonna put the pivot down here, and I'm just gonna sort of lightly tighten it for the moment. My goal mostly is to make sure that the button lock doesn't come flying out. But what we see here is that we haven't screwed it up. The button lock, ooh, that's smooth too. Oh boy. It's a little loose, but still. But this way the button lock isn't going anywhere. The one spring in this system is now under control. And that's a good thing. Generally speaking, you want spring to be under control. Unless, well, I guess that's summer's job, right, is to control the end of spring anyway, so I digress. We're going to go on ahead and put a little bit here, and thread locker onto this part right here, twist this into place. Okay, so I got that tightened down here. This guy, I twisted in from this side, tighten that down. All right, so right now, the action is too loose. Holy crap, is it smooth, though. Let's go ahead and tighten this up a little bit more and see where we're at. Oh my god, is that smooth. Okay. At full tightness, this thing is glassy freaking... Oh man. I'm having unnatural feelings for this knife right now. That's... Oh boy, is that nice. Is there any play? There is zero play. Oh my god, is that smooth. If the ACC-01 action had been like this, oh man, would have been a whole different story, but this is so nice. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. This is why Phosphor Bronze is so good, people. I mean, seriously, it just, Oh, yeah, it's so nice. Anyways, I digress. The wife's going to be coming in here like, what the heck are you doing? Yeah, no, it's, I swear it's just a pivot. Anyways, I digress. So yeah, we are done here. That is now beautifully, beautifully smooth. Process was very straightforward. I am quite impressed with the action here, and I hope that you all will be quite impressed with the review, which will be coming up here before too long. So there you go. Hope this has been interesting to you. Have yourselves just an absolutely wonderful rest of your day. Bye now.